As many people may or may not know, the legendary author of perhaps the greatest dark fantasy story of all time, Berserk, Kentaro Miura had been displaying his talent as an artist and writer long before Berserk was first published. He technically wrote his first manga at the age of 10 years old for his classmates, and it was called, I'm not even joking here, Miura Ranger. That's just awesome. But I could not find any official artwork of this manga or any links to it, so it is probably most likely lost to history, unfortunately. However, it shows that Miura had an absolute passion for this art form that never died out. And though Miura did find success at a relatively early age, it wasn't just a flip of the switch into the limelight. He did have several projects that were rejected, and it seems to be that in Japan, several magazine companies that publish weekly or monthly manga series tend to have competitions where newcomers can send in their treatments, as it were, to weed out the new and upcoming talent. Miura wasn't able to win any of these, but he did score an apprenticeship under the equally legendary Gyoji Marikawa, the creator of Hajime no Ippo, an extremely famous and very long-running boxing-centric manga. By the way, I have seen the old anime for Hajime no Ippo, but I have not read the manga, and I definitely plan to at some point. But upon Miura's passing, Marikawa commented on Twitter that while working with Miura, he noticed his exceptional talent right away, and eventually dismissed him from being his assistant because he said, well, he had nothing else that he could teach him. He already recognized Miura at a level where he should be working on his own manga. He also said that at the time of their collaboration, Miura already had designs made for a character of his who carried a gigantic sword, and one can only wonder what those early sketches of Guts might have looked like. In 1985, at just 19 years old, Miura caught his first break. In order to apply to an art college, he made a one-shot manga called Futatabi. Reading through this, I had a smile on my face the entire time, just being able to look at the origins of what would become my favorite author. Futatabi is a short story that is far away from anything Berserk-related, except for maybe it showcases Miura's affinity for adding in a good love story. This is a sci-fi manga that is very reminiscent of Blade Runner, from the scenery, the clothing, and yeah, it's basically Blade Runner. Which would make sense since Blade Runner was released in 1982 and Miura would have been 16 at the time that he saw it, so I can imagine it probably had a very heavily influence on him growing up. The story itself, though, is much different and extremely straightforward. A girl winds up in a strange world that she does not recognize and is on the run from the law. She falls into the arms of our unlikely protagonist Rick, who works as a mechanic. And when he takes her home to keep her safe from those that are after her, and he offers her a shower, he is very shocked to find out that, well, she's got some titties. Also, she doesn't have a dick. So we understand that wherever she is a world where only men exist, and they have no concept of what a woman is, making her name of Venus be a little too on the nose, but it's kind of fun. From there, the entire story shifts into a chase as the authorities find out that she's being harbored and try to catch up to them. An old man that the protagonist works with agrees to try to help get them to safety, some kind of entrance in the mountains where he thinks that the girl came from or that they'll be safe. On the way, they are attacked and the old man is shot, and Rick and Venus make their way to the caverns of the mountains. The somewhat twist ending is that we learn that this is a city located deep inside of the earth, that the surface world was considered unlivable after devastation, and so humanity moved their way underground. The issue being that there was limited space underground and apparently people couldn't stop multiplying. So, those in power separated men and women to different areas and devised a way to procreate artificially. Rick and Venus return to the surface world after decades of being uninhabited by man to start anew, perhaps not unlike a new Adam and Eve scenario. One thing very noticeable about this one-shot compared to Miura's usual style is that there is very few double-page spreads, and most of the art is close-up images of characters speaking to one another. Perhaps Miura was just trying to get more comfortable drawing people, or maybe he wasn't as confident about his big sprawling images just yet. It is very cool to see him drawing futuristic technology, though. It's very, very far away from the medieval style that Berserk has. And we know that he is a huge sci-fi fan. There's even a Star Wars reference mixed in with one of the panels. It kind of makes me wonder what it would have been like if Miura decided to do a science fiction Blade Runner style story instead of diving into the medieval worlds. The next one-shot was actually released in the same year and was published in Fresh Magazine, though according to sources online, it was not very successful in its popularity. This one is called Noah, and this one continues the sci-fi aesthetic. But this one is much more of like a mix between Dune and maybe a Mad Max style, taking place in a post-apocalyptic wasteland, where it's a desperate fight for survival against the malicious people that are there just trying to survive. In this one, a woman who is being attacked by a bunch of bandits, yeah, similar to creeps that we've seen in Berserk before, she is rescued by a man with cybernetic enhancements named Noah. And as they travel, they are forced again and again to try to defend themselves and killing their assailants. And the moral question of the short story is, that is this what humans default to without law and order? Does it get easier to kill the more that you do it? And what is the true nature of mankind behind all the surface societal layers? Now, the questions it presents might seem complex, but the story itself is very basic, and most of the questions are asked verbatim rather than being the subtext of the story. Towards the end of the story, though, spoiler alert, our lead female character named Angel is killed, and Noah does go into a berserk-like rage, destroying the machines that did it. But upon her death, he does vow that she inspired him to try to bring the gentle nature of humanity back as much as possible, and that he would use his enhancements and power to be a more biblical-like figure, such as his name Noah suggests, and that she was very much like an angel, showing him what peace could be like and reminding him about the beauty of humanity. Again, very straightforward, and maybe a little bit cheesy, but you could see the beginnings of the ideas that Miura had in that he wanted to cover deeper, more meaningful themes within a space where he could also showcase exciting action scenes and fantastical elements. It wouldn't be long after this that Miura would begin working on a story that would eventually become Berserk. As well as he worked as the artist on a few projects for Bronson, the man who created Fist of the North Star, which again was a major influence on Miura's style. I mean, look at Kenshiro, and then look at Guts. Reflecting on these early works of Miura, though, was something really special, and I appreciate the origins of his work. And it's great because, and I don't mean this as an offense, but you can tell that these stories came from a 19-year-old. I can feel the passion and energy of somebody young wanting to make something great and exciting. And you know that the person writing this would go on to do such amazing things later on, as he eventually did and captured all of our hearts and imaginations with Berserk. So thank you once again, Kentaro Miura, for everything that you've done on your entire journey. If any of you guys have read these one-shots, let me know what you think of them in the comments below. Out of the two, I prefer Futatabi the best, but which one do you like better? And if any of these would have continued, what story would you have liked to see play out more? Anyways, that's it for today, but I'm going to continue to read Miura's other work outside of Berserk and review all of them for you. Thanks as always for watching, guys. Please give this video a like and a comment because it does help in the algorithm. I would really, really appreciate it. And if it's your first time here, please subscribe to the channel if you like this video for more manga, anime, movie, and whatever else kind of content I decide to put out here. Anyways, thanks a lot for watching, guys. Really do appreciate it. I'll talk to you next time.